Welcome
to a special presentation with your host, everyone's favorite silly animal, Fishy the Fish. Oh, thank you. Hello, everyone on YouTube, and welcome to a presentation by me, Fishy. Today's stencil.
Hey, who's got the remote?
Cubby!
What?
How many times have to tell you not to eat the TV remote?
Cells. They're all around the body. If you think there's only one cell inside our bodies, you are dead wrong. There's actually 100 trillion cells. So you might be thinking, what does this have to do with stem cells? Okay, we're going to get there. Stem cells are specific cells that does a specific thing. They repair or replace cells that manage to get destroyed or damaged. How could a cell get destroyed? Well, load a presentation. A cell could get destroyed by a virus. PK Flash, PK Fire, PK Freeze, PK Thunder, get engulfed by something else. But the worst one of all is... These cells, unlike others, don't really have a specific job in the body, unlike the red blood cells, like, for example, they carry oxygen. When they want for help, they may transform into a new muscle, blood, nervous tissue, bone, cartilage, and skin cells, but not a blue hedgehog, trainer, 13-year-old kid, etc. And once a cyborg who can't pop the glass once right in his... Wait! Anyway, these stains, except for the last four, were used to repair or replace old ones. They can also make duplicates to produce copies or clones. But they're also pretty rare, so expect to hear about only one of them inside our bodies. So this leads to my question. How do scientists rebuild body parts with stem cells? Well, before we get to that, we need to know what stem cells are also used.
Show me a moves.
Used for. Scientists are working hard to create stem cell treatments for every single one from Alzheimer's disease, spinal cord injuries, multiple sclerosis and muscular dystrophy to liver disease, kidney failure, diabetes, Parkinson's disease, nest hanging with a baseball bat, PA snowstorm, etc. Projects currently going on using stem cells are as follows. Building human corneas, that's the part of the eye that gives it the most power, and treating heart attacks by reprogramming stem cells from the bone marrow and growing new skin for grafting. Now, how many types of stem cells are there? Well, there are tissue stem cells, human umbilical cord blood cells, amniotic cells, and
Okay!
What? Why did you have to write this in the script? It's supposed to say the amniotic fluid stem cells, not amniotic stem cells. That's it! You are going to get it out! As I was saying, there are amniotic fluid stem cells, embryonic stem cells, and induced pluripotent stem cells. The tissue type are found in some of the, you guessed it, the tissue in the adult's bodies, like liver. They replenish cells inside the body, replacing those that are wear out. The human umbilical cord blood types are going to be up next, as the doctors use these as transplants to cure people with the CGD, or chronic granulomatous disorder. There's a problem, however. There may not be enough umbilical cord. It's tough to say. I'll stick with HUCBSC for now. As I was saying, there may not be enough in any one sample for transplanting. So stem cells, sometimes, for many donors, need to be pooled. The use of stem cells, wait, we already covered that already. Yada yada yada. amniotic fruit stem cells were able to produce bone, liver, and nerve cells. However, this isn't confirmed yet. Embryonic stem cells are the only cells that can evolve into any cells in the body. Those cells are found in few-day-old fertilized eggs. Induced pluripotent stem cells are artificially produced from adult cells like blood cells.
Come on!
Okay, it's now time to answer the question. From my source I've gathered, it's time to begin answering, how do scientists rebuild body parts with stem cells? The answer is, humans cannot regenerate a whole arm or leg. But some animals like me can regenerate a fin, a limb, part of the brain, and an eye even if it gets cut off. Good research going on suggests that humans might be able to control embryonic stem cells to actually regenerate a human body. So I've been able to produce a new question. Can we make adult differentiated cells, like the heart muscles, start dividing again? It'll be important to find out why mammalian heart cells inside humans lost its ability and it could be ever brought back. Let's talk more about regeneration. Animals like me regenerate body parts of their original shape after it's injured. But humans, like the ones watching this video, cannot regenerate human parts. Just not yet, currently. Stem cells accumulate in an injury site in a structure called blastomere. Ongoing research includes on how regenerative animals keep a kind of map inside their adult tissues to tell the cells where they are and what they should be doing. Unfortunately, parts of this map may have finally! As I was saying, part of this map may have been lost in mammals, or perhaps the human stem cells must have lost the ability to actually read it. Researchers today still hope to find out what exactly is missing or blocked in the mammals, and whether such information can be restored in all of its glory. To develop stem cells to take part in regeneration for medical applications. My theory on how regeneration could work is by causing the created cells to stop the fighting to go back to the fighting and multiplying in order to replace lost tissue. Now, these three happened in a superficial heart regeneration, where heart muscle cell called the cardiomyocyte divides to replenish missing cardiac tissue. That was a bit tougher to say than the human rebuilt while. Only with research can we be able to widen soft tissues, possibly the weak one, and if we can ever recover. So, to summarize, stem cells are very rare out of the 100 trillion cells in our bodies. They can be transformed to help. The mammalian animals are going to read the map, and we learn about the many types of stem cells there are, and animals, me, can regenerate bodies, parts, but humans cannot. Put this source link in the description below for you. You can see the original articles of stem cell information that I've also explained in this video, some of which I may not have talked about. Welcome to a special presentation with your host, everyone's stupid animal, Fishy the Did you just call me stupid? Cut! There's actually 300 trillion cells that's like Hey! What is it supposed to be? It's supposed to be 100 trillion cells. 300? Never we do. You really have a good job, Yvonne. You're using the very poop. Okay, did I just say something wrong here? Cut.
They're extremely common in solid body.
What? Did I just say something? Cut.
You're kind of stone cell.
Wait.
Hey, can I have a redo?
Yes, we can have a redo, but you can have as many removals as you want, just because you screwed up one little thing. And if Monkey wrote this in the script, he's gonna get fired for sure.
Alright. Okay, just cover the camera. We need to do it.
I'm going to find a
cut! So does sometimes. Stem cells are very good. Out of the 300 trillion, it's actually 100. Hey! Thank you for watching this exciting video on stem cells. If you wish to follow all of us on YouTube, click the subscribe button if you haven't already. And if you could, please like the video and share it with your friends. And if you're looking for some antics or crush toys, you can probably need by clicking on the annotations above to go to the first two episodes of Total Crush Points. Sorry, mobile device users, you're going to have to follow the links in the description. See you next time!